Tell me, Patrick, I mean, you are a member of the Kennedy dynasty, often described as America's royal family. Whenever any member of the family gets involved in any kind of incident, it's always splattered across the papers, it's discussed on television shows, etc., etc. How much of a pressure does the family feel about that kind of thing?
Well, Pierce, like I said, in my own circumstance, I was very fortunate. My constituents in Rhode Island knew me. They knew I had challenges, but they also knew that I worked hard and I cared. And I got reelected after the arrest and the DWI, but I got reelected because I talked about it. I spoke openly about it because I knew that that's what my constituents wanted and that's what they were anxious to hear. And in fact, many of them started talking to me about their own sets of challenges that they felt ashamed about. And in a sense, Pierce, you know, even though I grew up in a very different way from many of my constituents, they related to my experience of fighting not only a mental illness, but the stigma that comes with that mental illness. And I think, Pierce, the greatest solution is that we need to open up the dialogue. We can't stigmatize these illnesses anymore. And I think not only in my own family's case, which is just another family out there struggling, this is a common struggle. There's not a family in America that doesn't have a child with a autism, a parent with Alzheimer's, a brother or sister with addiction or depression. You know, these are all illnesses that affect our behavior. And then we can't reject our family members because they act strange. And of course, we do because we call them crazy, nuts, psycho. These are all the pejorative terms that we use to describe people who are suffering from a mental illness. And who would want to be acknowledged as having suffered from a mental illness if they're called those words? We need to change the dialogue and open up our arms and our hearts to all around us because, as I said, Pierce, it's every single family in America.